security and political area, we are also take our responsibility in economical area, in economic area. For example, at the level of the regional economic communities, we have 8 regional economic communities in Africa. The ECOWAS, the ECAS, the SADC in the south, COMESA in the eastern part, in the northern part we have the CENSAD, and they are working for the economic integration within the region. And they are already doing a great achievement toward establishing a common market, toward establishing also customs union, and toward establishing the free movement for goods and for population. At the end of the day, we also aim at establishing a currency, a common currency named Afro, like euro, why not? So there are some great achievements, there are a lot of initiatives, and as you said, the organization is more structured now. We have launched a common position in different areas. We have policies, programs, but now the most important is how to implement. Time is now for implementation, not only in Africa, but within all countries in Africa. And we also developed our partnership, because we can't be alone. We can't be alone in Africa for this great work we have to do in Africa. We need our partners.
Well, let me come, because we have these people from the United Nations here. Let's turn for a minute towards the United Nations. The United Nations, as we all know, has a central organ, which is the Security Council.
Yes.
And that Security Council officially has one table with 15 seats around it. But that's not the truth. The truth is that there are two tables. There's one table with only 5 chairs. Mm-hmm. And at this table, they eat caviar and smoked salmon. And then you have a second table of 10 chairs where you eat bones and hot dogs. Now,
yes, that's true.
The African, what is the African position on this Security Council, which is totally anachronistic? This is a child of 1945, but we are in 64 years old, and we still haven't understood that the world in 2009 is not the world of 1945. Now, you represent 1/4 of the total population of the United Nations. So you are, as far as I'm concerned, the most powerful ambassador at the UN. What are you doing about it?
I think, Professor Kamal, you have to be one of those a member of the Security Council to allocate one seat for us, at least. But you know, we, as you said, we deserve really to have seats, at least 2 seats, because what we target is 2 seats at the Security Council. We have a common position on this issue. We have a so-called Ezuluni consensus. And in this Ezuluni consensus, the African leaders, they said that Africa needs to have 2 permanent seats plus 5 non-permanent seats and 2 permanent seats with a veto. As far as the veto exists, so we also claim to have a veto. But when one day the veto don't exist, so we don't claim the veto, but for the time being, that is the position of Africa. And then how Africa will choose its representative, it will be among Africa, among African countries. That's what we put in this Ezuluni consensus. Now, at the moment, we have the intergovernmental negotiation, which is ongoing within the General Assembly of the United Nations. There are already some proposals from various groupings, and not only Africa, from the G4, from the United for Consensus, from the Small Five, and so on. There are already a great exchanges on this issue. But I think for us, and everybody agreed, Africa deserves really a seat within the United Nations. We wait what will be the outcome of this first round of negotiations. Then we'll come back to our heads of state. We will meet in July. The next summit of the African Union will be in July. And this issue is all the time on the agenda of the summit in July.
Yes, but you know that under Article 108 of the UN Charter, no change can be made in the United Nations except with the approval of the five who are the caviar and smoked salmon eaters. They control everything, including any change in the UN. Right. Please explain to me, why should they allow you to get a seat on the table to eat caviar? Why would they allow you to come forward?
You know, among these five, we have China, we have United States, France, UK, and Russia. Four of them, they already agreed to have Africa when we follow the discussion. They said that Africa really deserves to have a seat within the Security Council of the United Nations. One of them who has caviar and vodka, maybe he will change his mind next time. But for sure, discussions are already going now. So I think Africa has a good chance really to have at least one seat.
I find you very optimistic about it.
That's what my husband said. We are too optimistic. No, but you know, all the time we are bored with this appellation of Africa as Afro-pessimism. So that's why I try to be optimistic for Africa. No, we need that.
But Ambassador, it is not a question of what Africa deserves. That's not the question. Mm-hmm. The question is of power sharing. It is a principle that those who have power never want to share it with those who do not have power. Why should those who have power want to give you any part of that power? It's not natural.
Because, you know, everything has changed with the, you know, the geopolitical situation is not the same as, for example, 40 years ago. So I think it is for their interest really to share the power, to open the Security Council, because all the issues on the agenda of the Security Council are on Africa, and Africa is now taking more and more part in peacekeeping operation. And now within the Security Council, the discussion is now how to make better coordination between the United Nations and the regional organization in peacekeeping operation, because they are overwhelmed with all this peacekeeping operation. They need our partnership in Africa more and more. That's why it's their interest to have us within the body.
I don't understand that. Just because you have problems, we should allow you to become a decision maker? Merely because you have so many problems?
We have problems. We know better than over why we have problems. That's why sometimes there is a need for us to have a chance to be within this Security Council as a decision maker. So it's not the power of money to have a money to be a member of the Security Council. You have also another input to make in the Security Council.
Okay, let me ask you just two or three questions before we open it to the floor. First of all, whether you like it or not, Africa is a backward continent. You are very rich, and yet you are very backward. Why are you so backward? Is it because your governance is bad? that you have bad governance?